Hello and welcome to the new Power BI tutorial where I will show you the custom Power BI tool tips. Let me correct the name. Which is adding complete report page as a tool tip. So this is very useful in scenarios like this where you want to add the sort of a visual information or a chart or something to your existing chart. As a tooltip. So when somebody is hovering over to your existing chart, a new chart or a new page is basically showing as an entire tooltip. Very, very useful and very, very interactive. So let's see how we can do that. And before I show you, just a quick information that this sheet, which has my previously posted videos with the link, is present in the description so that you can easily access it without much issue. And you can search any video and directly jump to it by clicking on the link here, right? So just to keep life little simple. All right, now let's come to here where we need to create the custom tooltip based on a page. So right now, if you see, if I hover my mouse over to any of the bar, only it is showing you the subcategory and sales. And in the previous video, I have shown you that you can add more fields here like profit, quantity, anything you add it here in the tooltip, you will be able to get it. But what if you want to have it an entire, let's say, a particular table or another chart, whether this chart or any line chart or anything, then in that case, we need to do some configuration. So first thing first, we need to create new page. So let's click it over here. And in this page, let's give it a name as tooltip. And you have tooltip over here. In this tooltip, we need to go into the format, right? And over here in the page information, you can see that name is tooltip. And we need to enable this tooltip. So this particular option we need to enable. So now this page is enabled as a tooltip. After that, we need to go into the page size. And in the page size, by default, it is 16:9. And we can choose anything, but for now, we will choose it as tooltip. So now the page size is reduced to use it as a tooltip. Okay, but you have the option. You can use entire page, 4x3, a letter, or any custom. Right, for now I have just chosen the tooltip. So what I want to show you over here, see, I have the product subcategory. Now I want to show a table which should show me that for these appliances, what is my customer categories. So customer category or the customer segment is present here, whether it is corporate, home office, or the third one is also present. So what type of customer segment it is. So what I will do is I will come over here in tooltip and click on this table, right? And on this table, I will pick the segment. Segment is present here, right? I will add this and I will add the sales as well. So what you have is a very simple segment and sale for each of the product subcategory, all right? And make sure that you have keep all filters enabled. Otherwise, the information here will not be filtered based on the particular type of subcategory. For example, we want to show appliances, only appliances specific customer segments and their sales. So now, once we are in this chart, we need to come over here. We need to make sure, first of all, we select, come here in the format and go down to include the tooltip. So by default it is default tooltip, but we change it to a report page and the page name itself is tooltip, right? So now our tooltip is enabled. So we come back over here and if you see, the tooltip for appliances is showing you the three different segment, the consumer, corporate, home office. Similar, and 107,000 is what you are getting it. Similarly for art, you just have $27,000 of sales and the sales is distributed into three different segments. So clearly consumer is buying more than corporate than home office. So this type of new visualization or new tooltip is something what you can create based on all the configurations we have done. So experiment with it, try create new types of things. For example, we have this sales of 78,000 for these categories. Try showing a trend chart, like month on month how much sales is coming. That can be another view, just to give them the idea that whether the sales is increasing or decreasing for a given category. So that's about it, and I'll meet you in the next video with a new topic.